Hi, this is Ed Chester reporting for Trusted Reviews. We've finally got our hands on the Samsung Galaxy Tab, which has just been launched officially here at IFA in Berlin. So it's a 7-inch touchscreen tablet running Android 2.2. It's got an OLED display that's, I think, 800 by 480 resolution. So because it's OLED, really nice viewing angles. Although it's got this same kind of really saturated colour look that we've seen from previous OLED displays. Style-wise, well, it's a tablet. It's not too much you can say. Obviously smaller than the Apple iPad, being only a 7-inch device. But they're kind of more usable because of that, much lighter and much easier to hold in one hand. So let's have a look at some of the features. Let's go straight to the browser. You can see we've got Trusted Reviews loaded here already. First thing you can see, it runs Flash. It's got our video running here. Running nice and smooth, although kind of quite fast almost double speed. I'm not sure what's going on there. Go back to the home page. There you can see it's nice and fast. All told, rather impressive actually. One new feature here is the Reader's Hub, which as you can see has news, books and magazines. If we go into books here, go back a couple of steps, you can see rather familiar looking interface there, somewhat like the Apple iPad. Go back into a book, usual sort of interface we can swipe through. And it's a very readable experience actually, very nice indeed. Change the font size as you expect. And despite the lower resolution than the Apple iPad, it's as I say, still a very, very usable device. So what else do we have? Need for Speed Shift here. Racing game. As with all these tablet and phone type devices, it's using tilt, which is, well, some of us don't like it that much. We'd rather have on-screen controls, but it works quite well. As you can see, it's pretty fast. Fairly slick 3D interface. Not bad at all. Otherwise, it's a standard Android 2.2 device. You get all the usual applications. Although Samsung's given it its usual overhaul to the look and feel, which we're not fans of overly, because they put these kind of backgrounds on the icons, which makes them a bit difficult to actually see what they all are. But otherwise, very impressive. Features-wise, we've got proper speakers on the bottom here. Custom dock here, which we haven't seen the... Well, here's a dock here, which this plugs into. And we presume it's a USB out the back. We haven't actually looked at that output yet. Audio out through there and a USB out through the side there. Otherwise, headphone jack on the top there. And camera on the back with the flash, which isn't a dedicated button for. On the side here we've got micro SD slot, so you can expand the storage, and a SIM slot for mobile data. All in all, very impressive.